Hello, grooming lovers.
Hello.
Today we are in a place called Bačka Topola. It is a 1 hour drive from the city we live in. Actually, this is a place that we got Granny from. You know the Granny, the old and blind dog that we rescued. And we have a dog that is in a pretty bad shape. I'm just going to step out of the car to show you. Just a minute, okay. How he looks. I don't know how much you can see. It is a Hungarian Puli male. He is pretty friendly, but he is in a pretty bad shape. And he was found by one lady. And she posted him on Facebook. So we came here to pick him up, give him a groom, take him to the veterinarian, and then first find him temporary home, and then find him a permanent home. Okay, this is my parents' car. Actually, we were on our way yesterday to pick him up, but we had our car. And it stopped like on the, okay, my mom's toy. It stopped in the middle of the highway and my car is now at the mechanic. So we are taking this car. Never mind. Okay, we will see you in our grooming salon. Okay, this boy seems very friendly. As you can see. And I think that he's going to be a great pet to someone. Before I start this groom, I just want to give three mentions. First is to my friend Gordon Rokvic, who takes care of more than 20 dogs. I'm going to put the link of her Facebook profile and her PayPal account so you can see that she's very active on her Facebook, and if you want to help her out, you can. The second is my friend who makes music for dogs to make them less stressful in certain situations like fireworks, grooming, traffic and stuff like that. His name is DJ for Dogs. And the third is my friend who made a website to sell beds for dogs and cats. His site's name is Pet Shop Rea. And make sure that you go to that site and see what he has. Okay, I'm just going to put this dog on the table and answer my phone because I can feel it vibrating in my pocket. Just a second. Okay, that was my auto mechanic saying that my car is done and ready to be driven. So, okay, I'm just going to let him sniff the clipper. I think that this dog had an owner. He does not have a microchip, but he's very good with people. He's also great on walking on the leash, which is just amazing. So I think that he had an owner, but when they posted him on Facebook, no one replied, no one called about him, so he is here now. Okay, I'm going to start grooming him with a 10. Okay, I'm going to start on his body. Okay, I didn't take this off. Okay. So 10 blade on the body. Okay, this blade got dual is because we used it a lot on the matted dogs. No. See, it's all in one big piece. Now I'm going to take the scissors and it's just so hard to scissor because this hair is so thick, and you should never do this with your new scissors because you will get them dull in a matter of seconds. And this is definitely going to be a great relief for him. Okay. I just want to thank everyone for your PayPal donations. It helps a lot to pay for the vet and for the food for these dogs and for the temporary home. Okay, this dog seems to be neutered, if I'm not wrong, which is great. One surgery less. Okay, I'm just going to do the tail now. And this dog is great for now. Hopefully he will stay that way till the end of the groom. Yeah, this is my new camera. This is my second video with this new camera. It is a GoPro Hero 10. Please let me know if you like it. If you see the difference in image quality, I can see it. Okay, this dog is not neutered, I was wrong. It's also much easier to groom a male that is neutered, because you don't have to worry about his testicles. Yeah, one thing, this is a Hungarian pulley. And these dreads that he has, his legs and his stomach, when you prepare a Hungarian pulley for the dog show, you let these dreads grow, but you don't just let it grow and take care of them. You take the dog to the groomer and he makes them and he takes care of them and makes sure that they don't turn into a one giant matting like on his back. So a lot of people that have a Hungarian pulley will just let the hair grow and think that that is okay, and it is not okay, because if you want your dog to have dreads, you have to take your dog to a groomer that is going to maintain them clean and make sure that they don't turn and become one big pile of matted hair. That's why most of the dogs that we find neglected are Hungarian pulleys. Okay, so I bought these two sprays, Andes and Oster, for blade lubrication, disinfection, and to cool the blade. Okay. I think that I like this Oster more, because as you can see, this Andes blade is not in spray, but like that. And it just spits drops of water and it gets a blade pretty greasy and oily. That's why I like the Oster more. Okay, I'm going to start from this side And actually this blade is very cool now. This spray did an amazing job. Guys, thank you again so much for your support, not just on PayPal, but also on YouTube. I've been receiving a lot of great comments about me, about Sanya.
Thank you.
About our work. And now we have around 133,000 subscribers. And at the time I post this video online, it will probably be even more. I mean, it will definitely be more. Okay. I'm going to lift him up. Hey. Okay, I'm going to spray this blade a little more. Okay. The legs are done. Going to change the blade. Another 10. Okay. Okay, yeah, this is a tick. This is the actinone, a fluid that kills ticks and fleas. Okay, we're going to take a little break, let the dog chill out, and then continue after that. Just going to try with scissors. Okay, that's pretty good for now. When I give him a bath, the mud is going to come off and it's going to be easier to shave that paw, but it's much better than it was. And you can see that he has a lot of hair in his ears. And I'm going to leave it for the end. When I do the head, I mean, when I shave the head and shave the ears, I don't know how he will react to this, but this is just too much hair in his ears. Okay. We have to finish this groom. We have to take this dog to a veterinarian, do all the tests, and then we have to take him to his temporary home, so we have to proceed. Okay. Going to do this part behind the head. Okay, this is another tick. Okay, fleas. This is the actinone mixed with water. Does not stink or anything. It's just not used to being sprayed. Yeah, something here. Looks like he's missing the part of his ear. Maybe some other dog attacked him and bit him there. Okay. It's another flea. We're going to bait him with the Ectanon, but I'm going to kill as much as I can before the bat. Okay, let's finish this here first. Changing the blade again. Okay. Okay. He has a lot of eye boogers. Okay, I'm going to do this area around the eyes. After the bath, I'm going to try to take it all off while bathing him. Hey, okay. Hey. Okay, so he has a lot of hair in his ears. So I'm going to pull little by little to make it less unpleasant for him. So this is what happens when you don't pluck the hair from your dog's ears. Luckily, this dog is behaving great. Okay, imagine having this in your ear. He does have more hair here. Okay, this ear is also bad. Okay. Okay, hey. Still a big piece. I don't want to pull it out in one piece. I think that it would be very painful for him and unpleasant. A little more. Hey. Okay. That is done. Hey. Okay, this year is great. There are still some heroes left, but they're just a few of them that won't make you any problems. And I just want to finish this leg now. I mean, finish this first shavedown and then give him a bat. Actually, I'm going to give him a break then. And then after a break, we're going to give him a bat. After the bat, we're going to shave his body again, make it all nice and even, and then go straight to the vet. Hopefully he's healthy. And this dog was pretty lucky. First of all, he was found by a lady who kept him before we came. And also posted him on Facebook. And she also kept him one day longer because, as I said, yesterday we had problems with my car. And yeah, he was also lucky because we are going on a travel. We're traveling in 5 days. Sanya and I, we're going to Zanzibar in Africa. And we're going to stay there for 10 days, I mean 10 nights. Can't wait to go. This is probably my last groom before we go. Don't worry, the dog is going to be a temporary home. Okay, I know that he doesn't like me touching his front feet with clippers, so I'm just going to do it with scissors as much as I can. And also, I can maybe take some parts here off with scissors, so there's less to take off in the bat. I'm going to check his nails. His nails seem fine. And these nails on the side. Yeah, I need to clip this one. Okay. That's fine. That's it. We're going to clean everything up, clean the blades, clean the table, disinfect everything, and also give him a little break before we take him to the bathtub. Okay, we disinfected everything and prepare for the bath. Just want to give him some water. Thank you. boy is thirsty. And we're going to give him some food. He doesn't mind me touching him while he's eating, which is great. Okay, that is enough. Going to get him to the bathtub now. Okay. I'm going to set the camera angle a little bit better. And yeah, this is my famous girlfriend's apron, as you all know.
That's my apron.
Ta-da. Okay. Hopefully he's going to act. He's going to behave. Nice. And we won't have any trouble bathing him, but we'll see. Okay, I'm going going to start with some warm water, not too warm. I'm going to wash his paws first. He does not mind getting wet, which is great. I'm going to try to remove these eye boogers. We are applying that much water on his feet because we want to get all of the dirt and mud out. You saw that there was a lot of dirt on his feet. I'm going to shave the paw pads, this here after the bath. Okay, I'm going to soak his coat first. I'm hoping that the camera angle is good. Okay, we're going to apply the Ectanon. Okay, I didn't put water on his head. And the Ectanon is going to kill all the fleas left. Okay. Seems to be enjoying it. See that dead fleas are coming out. I mean, they are trying to escape, but the Ectonon is killing them. They cannot come out if they're dead. Okay, so we're going to leave this for like 10 minutes and then we're going to rinse it. Okay, Sanya is going to rinse him. Yeah, these are all dead, please. Okay, we're going to give him his first dose of shampoo. Going to wash him from this side so everything would be faster. The reason why there is not a lot of foam is because his hair is very short. Okay, I think that this is enough. Okay, the first shampooing is done. Now we're going to apply the second shampoo, and after we rinse that, we're going to apply the dog conditioner, and then he's going to be clean. Okay, after the bathing is done, Sanja is going to soak the water from his coat with towel, and then another big test, the blow dryer. Hopefully he's going to act great like he did on the bathing, but we will see. This area is shorter because the hair is growing in the opposite direction, and that's why this area is shorter. It's very funny. Okay, we're going to put him on the table now. See how clean the table is, and the blades are also disinfected and clean. I also cleaned the clipper with the ethanol because, you know, I'm touching it all the time. And I'm going to put this back on. Možeš malo da ga ja držim. Ok. That's enough. It's very stressful for him. And the hair on the head is very short. So... and in here is very warm, so it is going to dry naturally. I want to make sure that the ear canal is dry and clean. That's my biggest concern. Some kind to... This is the ear cleaner I use. I'm just going to pour some drops here. Thank you. Ricky this year looks very good now. Now the second I'm also going to add some cleaner. He was great for the bat, he was also great for the blow dryer until we started drying his head. But luckily his hair is short and until I shave his body again he's going to be completely dry. Okay, his ears are clean. And now I'm going to take this little clipper and do his paw pads. Also going to do around his butt with this. This little clipper is very handy. So we did the most important parts. We took the matted hair off, we killed all the fleas, we cleaned his ears, and we gave him a bath. Now these are all just details. Details are not that important, but actually they're not important for the dog, but they're important if you want to adopt him faster, because the dog is going to look nicer. See, the paw pads are very matted. I mean the front paw pads. Okay, paw pads are done, and all I have to do now is shave his body again. Like that. And all I have to do now is do his head again. I'm going to do his ears first with a 10. No. I'll do as much as I can, and I don't want to hurt him at the end. He starred. And yes, we're going to make a Facebook and Instagram profile for our work, so we can post pictures of the dogs and you can see how they're doing. We can post a status on Facebook and stuff like that. We don't always have to post a video. Have a lot of pictures of the dogs we saved now, and they're in temporary home or in permanent home. So I think that it will be interesting to you to see how they're doing. And it's sometimes hard to do it all through YouTube, because YouTube requires a video. I know that now there are stories on YouTube and stuff like that, but it's easier and you have a Facebook profile too, and where people can also follow you. Does not have eye boogers anymore. Okay, we are done. It's all nice and even now. He's not matted anymore. His ears are finally clean. He does not have fleas. He does not have ticks. And I'm just going to take this blue color. He's a great dog. We will see what the vet says. I'm hoping for the best that he does not have any diseases and that he can go into the temporary home today. And after that, I'm sure that he will find a great home. So great, he's not longer on the street. The winter, I mean, it's currently winter, but stronger winter is coming soon. And who knows? Would he survive on the street? Okay. As you can see, he's happy. He can now feel when someone is touching him. It probably feels great for him. Yeah, his ears are itchy. But he's going to be great. We're going to give him a walk now and give him some more food and take him to the veterinarian. And that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Again, thank you for the PayPal tips. Please support my friend Gordon Rokvić and support DJ for Dogs, and take a look at my friend's online shop, Pet Shop Rea. Everything will be in the description of this video, and we're probably going to pin a comment. And thank you for watching this video again and supporting us, and we will definitely see you soon.
Bye. Thank you, bye.
Mm-hmm.